So in this video, I'm going to create a formula that will accomplish something like sum if or count if with OR criteria in both Excel and Google Sheets. So I'm gonna start in one of those. It doesn't really matter. Let's start with Excel. So we have, let's say, some sales reps here in this column. Let's just highlight that. And we have some sales amounts. And generally, if you do sum ifs, you can only do and condition. So let's say you wanted to do OR to be able to grab, let's say, Jennifer, Jose, Jake, something like that, and get the total. So this is what I'm gonna do for that. I'm gonna start by typing a couple of names here. I'll do Isabella, and we'll do Olivia. And notice I'm entering those names in columns. So now I'm gonna create a formula here. And the way I'm gonna make that formula, I'm gonna take this column of sales reps right here in this column, and I'm gonna do a test, a logical test, to see if that equals to this. And I'm gonna select these two values in columns. I'm gonna hit enter so you can see what I get out of this. So if you look here, I got two columns of results. The first column would now belong to Isabella. So if we look at Isabella, see, like this line, we get a true. Then if I keep going through this list, I'm gonna get another Isabella, and that's true too. And all the other cases are false in this column. Now, if I check this second column here, that's for Olivia. And as you can see here, we have Olivia, that's true. We have another Olivia here, that's true. And the rest of the cases are false. With the same logic, if I go and add Jake here and simply just change this array to also include Jake, like this, that should now add another column for Jake, and every time it's Jake, it's gonna say true. Hopefully that makes sense. I'm gonna undo to just get two columns for now. So now at this point, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take this true and false values, and I'm gonna convert them to ones and zeros instead. And a very easy way to get that done is to basically use this function n. So that's function n, just like that. I'm gonna wrap that whole thing, hit enter. And you'll see now all trues became ones and all falses are zeros. So why is this useful? So if we're trying to figure out how many instances of Isabella and Olivia we have in this column, we could simply just count once. So we can just say 1, 2, 3, 4. And there it is, we have four of them. So to do that easily, we could just put this whole thing inside of a function sum, just like that. Sum will sum up all zeros to zeros and ones to that total number. So there it is, four instances of those. So we got Isabella, Olivia, and then Isabella and another Olivia someplace. There it is. Four of them. So that's our count if, basically, with OR statement. And you could do more here. So if I go and do Jake and simply just expand this range to include that, all the three names. This one is hiding behind the formula, but it's there. So now we got seven of those. Again, I'm gonna undo to just get back to two, but it works just fine. Now, the next thing you might want to do, you might not want to actually have these values here, and you might want to have them in the formula directly. So what I can do, I can just highlight this part, press F9, and that will basically just hard code the array in the formula, see, with those names, and that will be our OR condition count if. And obviously you can go here, add a comma, and put your names comma separated in quotes, just like that. So now let's try to do sum if with OR. So for that, I'm gonna undo a little bit to get to this point. So if you remember, this was where I did that logical statement, and then I just converted to 0 and 1. So what I could do now, I could take these zeros and ones and simply just multiply that whole array by this column of sales amounts. So if I go ahead and hit enter right now, you'll see that what will happen every time we have Isabella, her sales amount will show up here in this column. And there's another one, Isabella, right here, that sales amount showed up here. For Olivia, it's going to be the same. So we got Olivia here. So you can see that amount for Olivia shows up here in this column. And this shows up in this column. So again, if we wanted to get the total of all of these, zeros will add up to zeros anyways. So the rest of the numbers will get us the total. So now I can just do sum of this whole thing. And that would give me the total for Olivia and Isabella combined. Now again, you can hard code those names here. So I can just highlight this and do F9 and do a hard coded array. You could also type, but this is easier. Isabella, Olivia, and that's gonna give us the same total. Now you wouldn't have to have those names listed here, and that gives you your total, and you can obviously add commas and do other names. And finally, if you wanted those names to be maybe listed here in a row instead of different columns, I'm gonna grab these three names, paste it here. So all I would have to do, because these need to be in columns for our formula to work, over here, instead of just referring to that, I'll do transpose and select those three values, close parentheses. Transpose will basically take these things that are in rows and put them in columns, and that should still work for our formula just fine. So if I change this one to John, let's actually do that correctly. There it is. We'll get our totals. I'm going to undo a couple of steps here again, get back to this one. So all these formulas should work in Google Sheets. You would need to convert it to an array formula for this to work. So if I just copy this formula, hit escape, go back to my Google Sheet and simply just paste that same exact formula right here. All I have to do to make this work, just wrap it inside of array formula. And I can do that by either doing Control Shift Enter, or you could just write this array formula function around this. And if I'd enter, I'm gonna get my total. See, 15,041, and that should be the same thing here, 15,041. And just to verify that this is actually accurate, let's just do a quick check. So this was for Isabella and Olivia. So we'll just do this plus this, plus this, plus this. I think that's it. So if I hit enter, that's our number. And that should do it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.